Welcome to the 2022 Winter Instrumental Music Concert. Well, just tonight, it's actually just band. Mr. Hoy, the orchestra director, came down with a pretty serious illness. He's going to be okay. He could not be here tonight, and therefore he wanted to be here to conduct his students. So the program tonight is just reflecting the band portion. It was kind of, as I was telling the students, it was kind of a program tonight was kind of a band sandwich, orchestra being the bread. Band right in the middle there. So just look at that middle portion of your program there. And we already played one of our tunes there, and we have four more, and that'll be that for tonight. The orchestra, the high school orchestra, for those of you wondering, they're already looking at possibly performing at Cedarbrook's orchestra concert next week. They'll have them there, or doing something in January. So they'll have their opportunity to perform, and we're all looking forward to that, but we're missing them here tonight. Nonetheless, we are here, the band is here. It's been great to get to know these students here on the stage. The wind ensemble class and our percussion class here joined forces with the band. We have a few selections we're playing for you here tonight. And the first one, Renaissance Suite, about 500 years old. That was pulled from like three French Renaissance era dances. You could imagine they might be played around the holiday season, but not specifically there for. But we are moving about 200 years more into the future. Trust me, we'll get to the 21st century. But we're gonna move from the 16th century to the 18th century. We're gonna play some Bach for you. Air for Winds, based on Air on a G String, which you might recognize this song by Johann Sebastian Bach, Air for Winds. Thank you. So as my percussion class is setting up, I just want to share a few things. We've been working for about 3.5 months now. Towards the beginning of the school year, a lot of it was establishing a lot of basics of sound, how to produce sound, a lot of basics of how to hit these things properly, and really all get on the same page technique-wise. This music, the first two pieces you heard, what I was trying to, the educational purpose of those pieces really teach a lot about contrast, different color. And that first piece you heard, the Renaissance Suite, you could hear kind of the woodwinds versus brass kind of thing going on, loud versus soft. And then a piece that we just played, that Air for Winds, that piece, frankly, it's been slow, tipping off a little bit. So the challenge there is, how do you make something like that dramatic? How do you add those dynamics to it? So we worked a lot with that, developing our, as wind players, developing our tone quality. Up here, we have our percussion ensemble, our percussion class. About 4 or 5 years ago, at the advice of a colleague from another school district, I actually created a percussion-only class. Prior to that, as is traditional in most high schools, the whole band, percussion, woodwinds, brass, all are in the same class. But ultimately, pedagogically, they're very different. And so with the songs that we play together, the winds and the percussion, we meet a few times, we practice a few times, we put those things together as we learn them separately. But as I said, with the I can really focus on wind-specific things, breathing, really develop tone quality, airstream that, frankly, these guys, they don't care about. They're concerned, and we're going to be more concerned about how to hit things properly, all right, to put it crudely. All right, how do we all get on the same technique playing field? And that's this next song. This is going to be a rude awakening, wake up from the last song. All right, this song's called Shockwave, and really the educational goal of this song is to get everyone in the same place with our hands, work our fingers, make sure they're all working together, and hopefully see a lot of unity in what is going on with their hands. Again, still working on the same kind of things like dynamic contrast, and this is going to be a fun one, Shockwave. Thank you. So some more technical things up here for this next song. This next song was only written a few years ago in 2019. Really fast forwarding here, pretty fast. And Off the Edge by Alex Shapiro. When I bought this song back in August or early September, the composer actually wrote to me directly saying thank you for choosing this song. And she gave me some pointers on what to do, how to do this sound setup all correctly. And this is, in the classical world, what is referred to as an electroacoustic piece of music. Because mostly in the classical world, you're using acoustic instruments. When you introduce something digital electronic, they call it electroacoustic. Sounds pretty fancy. But basically, this song was a great way for our students to explore something completely different from what we did in the first couple of songs. Explore different styles, explore unique rhythms, and of course, the challenge of playing with an electronic part is also a totally unique thing. I doubt any of these students have done with this instrument on stage before. So we have these speakers set up. The students have some speakers sent to them so they can hear what's going on. So almost more of a contemporary kind of music experience with these kind of stage monitors and everything. And I'm going to end right now and just say what the composer wrote in the score here. Quote, "What happens when a composer who loves the pop music of the 80s and 90s hangs out in dance clubs blasting house music of the 2010s? Off the Edge offers a 140 BPM thumping EDM jumping clue."
Thank you.
believe it or not, we're on to our last song. I want to thank everyone in the program, listed at the bottom of the program, contributes so much. And thank you for Mr. DeAndre for being here tonight. And yeah. And it's been great so far these past 3.5-4 months getting to know these students on stage. For a lot of them, in fact, all of them except for seniors, this is their first winter concert live at the high school. Last time we did a winter concert live was 2019. So the vast majority of these students up here, in a way, haven't done this winter concert before. On top of all the returning students, it's been great to get to know the ninth graders. We have a strong ninth grade class who's already contributed a lot. And really, one more round of applause for all the performers down there. And one more thank you. I want to thank all of you, particularly family members, who have encouraged your children to stay involved in the arts. If your child shows a great interest, thank you for putting up with buying the reeds, going to the repair shop, the instrument, getting the students to practice here and there, getting them here tonight. I don't take that for granted. As a father of now 3 young kids, I see it coming. I know what's going to happen. And I know I can recognize that this takes a lot. So family members, thank you for all of your support of these people up here, of this community, of the school district, and of music. Thank you so much. Let's give it a applause. And one final thing before we dive into our final tune. A couple of upcoming events in about 2.5 months. We have a big weekend here at the high school. We're hosting a jazz festival of 10 different bands, 11 I think actually now, Friday night, the Friday after President's Day, February 24th. And then the day after that, we're hosting about 30 different indoor drumline and indoor color guard groups for our competition that day, the day after the 25th. So that's gonna be a lot of fun. And then of course our spring concert on May 10th, coming way down the road for everyone up here, along with the jazz band will be at that. There's gonna be a few other events, but I just wanted to highlight those. And believe it or not, this is my 10th year here, and I have never played this classic Christmas tune that so many bands play. Here's Leroy Anderson's Sleigh Ride.